ETC Creo Parametric 3.0 Lesson 22 Part 4. This will be the shaft drawing. And on the PDF you get some example of the views that you could use. This can be done however you think it's important to show the features. Don't necessarily just go by what is given to you here. This gives you some example of some of the sections and that would be useful to detail the project. So I opened up the shaft and we're going to start a new drawing. I'll just leave the defaults for now. Now you're going to see something a little bit different on mine, because when I open this up, it's going to say these views do not exist. And that's because when I created this 10, 15 years ago, there were not standard views given to you on a template for the drawing. So I have to, though you will not have to do this, I have to go and put the views in there, which I really don't mind doing because I can get the views exactly like I want, hopefully. So front, what do I want to face the front? Well, what if I want this datum plane to face the front? And what do I want to face the top? So if this is the front, maybe I want this to face the top. And that looks pretty good. So I could put any view I want on there and then reorient it. You'll also notice that in these choices here, there are no standard views even in the model. That's again because this is a very old project that I modeled and I don't want to really change it. I want to use it as an example of a legacy part. So, okay, now let's see what we've got here. First of all, we are on a D size sheet. We are at 50%. Let's change the scale to 1. Maybe a good idea, may not be a good idea. And in fact, you might want a bigger sheet or you might want a smaller scale. I think I'm going to go back down to a little bit to 0.75. All right, so this is one view that's very important. I want some other views, obviously. So I'm going to project a view from the end. I may even want to project one from to both sides if I want to use it. And I'll reselect the middle view, the first view, and I'll project a couple of views off of that. Now, before I do any more, I'm looking at this and saying, well, okay, these views are good, but I really want a bottom view here. Not really. So let's move this down like so. So this becomes the front view, obviously. And we will project off of here. And we got quite a few views on there, probably all that's going to be necessary for a little while. Now, let's change our visualization on everything. And let's go into, I think no hidden line would probably be a good idea. I just used my middle mouse button and rolled it to repaint. I could have refit, repaint here. So let's see what we have as far as sections go. When you did the model, it would have been a good idea to add some sections. And if we look at this here, we'll see that when this was modeled, actually is an older style section creation process. So this one says there's no section, so I guess I must have deleted them. That's okay. So we want a cross section. We want a new one. It'll be planar. It'll be A. And we want it to go down the middle of the part. And I'm going to open up my model tree. And I'm going to turn off by deactivating and not show, making not show that one. All right. So the next one. Let's put a couple of other sections in here. How about one down the middle? Let's maybe we'll just do one more, and you can put as many as you wish. So, excuse me, I'm going to go into the section tool instead of the view manager. Either place is okay. And I'm going to click on datum features. This will be built into the feature of the section or the sectioning so that the plane isn't separate from it. So this is an internal datum plane. And I'm going to offset it from over here. And all I really want to do is bring it far enough so that it cuts through this portion here. It doesn't have to be any particular place as long as it cuts through. Again, you may want more than just this one. Okay, and then I'm going to resume. And uncheck that, like so. And again, I'll go back into my, excuse me, my model tree. Section is off, okay? So you can see it's not activated. So there's two different ways of getting at that deactivation and showing. All right, so I have a couple of sections in there. Excuse me. One thing I didn't do probably, I don't know what I call that section. I didn't call it the correct name I wanted, B. So type in B and hit enter. You don't have to use capitals. It'll automatically change to B, capital B. And let's go back over to our drawing. And I don't know why this changed, but it did because I changed it here. So this is going to be hidden line, like so. I think a better way of doing this would be to capture them all, go into properties, and instead of follow environment, put on no hidden, no tangent display, and complete that. Now, let's go look at what we have. Double click on the front view section, 2D cross section, plus. We have a green arrow here. Apply. Close that one out. You can double click on the section and you can change the spacing. A little closer. Like so. And one of the things we don't have is a view of the section, so we could actually turn this into a section view or this into a section view, because remember we cut it through this point here. So let's double click here and see what we can use. Sections, 2D section plus, section B, apply. And remember there is that arrow display way down here in this dialog, or you can use your right mouse button, and we want to display the arrow in the front. It's up to you if you want to display the other arrow. Click on the front view, add arrows, and click on the view above it, projection view, and put in that set of arrows. So we pretty much have everything we need. If you wanted to blow this up, obviously, I think one of the better things to do would be to put in a detailed view and select this portion here as per lesson 11 in the book and put in a nice detail to show the geometry here. And let's shut off all the datum features and let's go and go into our annotate tab, show, and let's click on just the features, not the whole view. So for instance, let's say I want this. I'm gonna hold down my control key and I want this. And that's the only thing I want to show in that view. Okay, that's the only feature I want to show in the view. Apply. Now, if you remember when we when I showed this when we were modeling, this is the old version of the shaft, and you'll notice that it does not have the proper 122 degree angle for the drill tip. And that was put in, remember we did that when we were displaying the complicated cross section here when we were modeling and putting in the revolved cut. And it was a revolved cut, I think that was an actual sketched hole. Regardless, you can move your dimensions around, etc. You want to establish your geometric tolerance and your datums A, B, and C. You want to do all the things normal for a drawing. as far as your sheet setup, again, that's something that if you, my layout tab, if I don't do that, I won't get my sheet set up. I could have just gone down here and double-clicked on the size and did the same thing without changing my tab. And let's just go to E size. Is that kind of big? Let's have a D size. Did it do it? No, it did not do it. size. Okay, there we go. And again, move your views around, do whatever is necessary. If you want to add a separate sheet and move some of these things there, you can do that also. But you really want to have a completely detailed drawing before you submit it. And all the dimensions are pretty much shown here. Yours might be a little bit different, and that's okay. And you may decide to display the end different views and do it a little bit differently as far as the as the requirements for the drawing are. This completes part 4.